So today we have a 1917 Cadillac, and I believe she's been parked for about 93 years. She's 104 years old, but she's been sitting for about 93 of them years. She does have the V8 in her. The back half's mostly gone on it, but the engine's complete, the transmission's complete. The part we want to get running's all there. She does have the good old V8 in her, and whoever bought this car back then had to be doing pretty good because it costs the equivalent of about $100,000 today. This old car was $4,000 back in the day. We're leaving her on the trailer for now because the frame's about to come in half there. But under the hood, she's got the big old V8 engine that makes, I think it makes like 40 horsepower or 80. I may be wrong, but it don't make a whole lot for the, I believe it's 5.2 liters of displacement. I may be wrong on that. It just depends on where you look, what people say. But it is a V8. It does still have the Champion spark plugs in it, and it looks like they're all original. Everything's on it. That, I believe, is the starter motor, and everything's there. It's missing the little oil bottle because on these old ones, you got to oil your starter now and then. But she is complete for the most part. The motor is locked up, but I do believe that it is, the clutch may be stuck to the flywheel, and that's causing our whole problem. So we're going to drop the drive shaft later on and see if that is. First thing we're going to do is drain the oil out of it and fill her up with diesel fuel and take all them spark plugs out just to see. Don't want to break any rings in this thing or mess anything up because finding parts for this thing is almost impossible. I think for the little rotor button that's underneath the distributor, it's $105, and the distributor cap, I did find one finally after looking. And they're like $330 if you have to buy one. So we're just gonna hopefully not break anything on this one because parts are hard to find. And it may be because it's 104 years old, but I'm not sure about that. She's missing her radiator topper. So now we've got a socket that's the right size, some penetrating fluid. We're gonna clean the old engine off on this side, soak these plugs down, then go to the other side and start pulling these out. Hopefully we don't see any major rust in there because she was a runner when parked, I do believe. And I think we can get it running. And thanks again, John, for sending this thing. Makes this a lot easier and it works really good. TV blaster. Boy, that really does spray pretty good. We'll spray that too, even though we ain't doing nothing with them. We also have some Freol we might try out. Some people say that's better than PB Blaster, but this stuff's pretty good. So is just about any other penetrating fluid. Yeah, she seems to be coming out just fine. Bad thing about these is a lot of the times water gets filled up inside of the spark plug hole and the threads rust off in there and the plug just breaks off. This one, since it was inside for a long, long time and it had a hood on it that kind of kept, well, it did keep all the water off the top side of it. It does a lot for it. There we go. She's coming out pretty good. See what she looks like here. Well, got tight again. Surprised it's coming out that easy. Well, I'm gonna tell you, that doesn't look bad at all. So we got that spark plug out and that cylinder doesn't look terrible. I can see all the riding on the valves. It's a lot better looking than this one, but this one ain't just terrible. I did break the spark plug, sadly, but we're getting new ones. And these probably would have worked, but new ones would probably be better. I'm gonna skip the rest of these and get back with you guys once I have them all out. Unless I see some real interesting, or if one's real rusty, I'll show it to you. This one sprays a lot better. So we're gonna pull the old drain plug out of the car and see what it looks like. Hopefully the oil ain't too watery or anything like that.
Oh, that's nice.
That's... That smells like just straight gear oil or grease or... I don't even know. It's pretty nasty. We'll let that drain for the next probably month of Sundays, because this one, that ain't coming out too slow, but it's gonna take a while for that to get out of there. Then we'll fill her up. So now we got all the spark plug holes full of diesel fuel. We're gonna fill the crankcase full, and hopefully we have enough to do that, because it took quite a bit to fill them spark plugs. So it's been like 4 days since I filmed the first part of this video. The engine was locked up. I didn't think it was because the hand crank came loose, but the hand crank's just really hard to turn because it ain't had no one turning on it in about 93 years. So everything in there's rusted real good. I did spray it all down with Freol. The engine was stuck, but now she isn't stuck. I filled her full of diesel fuel, and then we filled her full of Marvel Mystery Oil, then some brake fluid, got her broke loose. At first, she wouldn't want to turn too good. Finally got her where she'll spin all the way around. I did have to pull the drive shaft and get a hold of it. We did it without breaking any rings or anything like that, I believe, because it came loose pretty easy, and when it'd get to a hard spot, I'd just kind of stop and let her set. And this engine, is since it's the earlier engine, it does not have heads on it. The heads don't come off. And it does make 80 horse instead of 40. I was off by 40 horse. For some reason, I thought it just made 40. But down here is where the head bolts are, and they're not really head bolts. The whole cylinder comes off the block, and there's no way to take the heads off. So I'm glad she came unstuck. Later on down the road, we may end up rebuilding this engine after we get her running and everything, because I think it'd be cool to put it in an old truck, like a 1917 Chevy or something like that, because I'm going to keep the old engine around because it just looks neat, and it's 104 years old. And there probably ain't many of these old engines kicking around anymore. And I get the question where I get all these old cars all the time, and truth is, they come from all over the place. The 29 GMC came from way up in Missouri. This coal car came from Wisconsin. And some of the other ones came from down here in Arkansas. And they come from all over the world. There we go. She's off. Now what do we do with her? Do we have any way to move it? I think we can pick her up on both sides and get her out of the way. Yeah, everything's now hooked up. We got the coil hooked up to the battery. We've hooked it up to here and into the old coil wire. Everything in the distributor should be ready to go. And I've ran the negative, well, positive to the coil and grounded it out down there where it's supposed to be. And we got a ground going there, so. One sec. This might take a few tries. Old girl's being a little temperamental. It's been a few days, and we have a few sticky valves in this one. To be exact, this one here, this one, and this one on this side. Also, that one stuck wide open. Either it just went down or I broke something. Either or. Been at this 20 minutes. Whoa, it really hit on that one. hidden.
We're hooked up though. Maybe it's not getting fuel.
Oops, throttle here.
Don't run after this, I don't know. That one hits just about every time, but at the wrong spot. So it has compression in all the cylinders, has pretty good compression. And we do have spark. I shocked myself like four times in the course of like a minute with it, trying to make sure we had good spark. I've held on to about every one of them on accident. They'll all shock you, so there really shouldn't be anything keeping it from running. And for some reason, the clutch fans just kind of decided to quit spinning. Not sure what that's about. Ooh. So I've been cranking on this whole thing for another probably 2 hours, 3 hours. I'm not kidding, and she just won't hit. I've changed the coil back and forth. I've changed out coils. I've went through the distributor cap again. We have these plug wires, which are good. They came off something that was running. I changed the condensers out again. We're getting good ground.
We ain't able to get this old Cadillac running. It seems like it's beat us for now. We are going to do a rebuild on it. But we've been working on this thing for on and off for a couple months now, just messing with it when we have time. And it just seems like it does not want to run. I was hoping it would, because it'd be the longest will it run we've ever got running, because it's been setting for almost 100 years. But it seems like maybe the camshaft or the, basically they have little deals that work off a cantilever kind of system down there. I think one of them, well, actually the ones on the other side of the engine, that side over there, I guess you call it the right-hand side, driver's side, whatever you want to call it, I believe them may be broken, because at first they didn't really want to open, and that could be why it was parked. I'm going to get that off of there. I'll let you guys know in the video when we rebuild this. Sorry it didn't run, but we can't win everyone, it don't seem. But thank you guys for watching, and hopefully you liked this video. And if you did, consider maybe subscribing and leaving a like, because we got a lot more videos where we get stuff running. Most of the time we win. There's only been three or four of them that have beat us. Well, this is one. But thanks for watching.